Hi, I am here to give a short introduction on the physics and basic principles of sonography. You have to have a strong foundation on basics of ultrasound for the best practice of sonography. Based on some basic principles of sonography, which are usually ignored and which are essential and to be kept in mind during performing the sonography, and modify the technique to achieve the best diagnosis. Here follows the snippets of all the topics in the lecture videos. Please go through them.
Having gone through the preview, if you wish to listen to the main lecture video, go to sonoshare.in. Going to cover is the basic principles. You can take it as tips and tricks for best practice of ultrasound. Yes, so if you use a high frequency, what the probe footprint, the probes have a footprint, that is the footprint pointed. This is the major advantage of this probe. You can apply a pointed compression so that you displace the gas cross section at this level, and you see that it is not calculus, it is actually the gas in the duodenum, adjacent duodenum or colon, which is causing the artifact that due to the, is it not seen well? Because what we are interested is the upper margin of the upper lip. So here you see the this part of the tibia is parallel to the beam. So when it is parallel, dropout artifact perpendicular to the beam in with a particular angle. So this part of the tibia, I have made it perpendicular to the beam, so it is seen well. That is, like, the angle of incidence is 90 degrees, you don't get any Doppler shift, so you will not see any color filling. That is why we don't get. So how to see in color? You go to the lateral approach again, because of the adjacent echo power ascites and also appendages seen very well when there is a contrast of ascitic fluid. Angle is seen because of the contrast of the amniotic fluid. Here it is not seen because the contrast of amniotic fluid is not there. So the meningocele sac is close to the UD. Structure will be better visualized because of an acoustic window, avoiding ribs, avoiding gas, etc. Or the angle of insonation may be perfect in a particular approach. Practically, theoretically shown, because of the spine here, we cannot take the pancreas from posterior aspect. Okay, but if you do, the image will look like this. Okay, but this can be done in a fetus. I'll show you how. So where is this applied? I told you one application. Second application is in the fetal echo. So in fetal echo, do the scan from the right flank. Then you see this is right, left, and you see gas is anterior, so with shadowing, fluid is posterior with enhancement. What I have done is, I have done a coronal scan from the flank. Why? Because the gas will be going to the non-dependent part, that is anterior part of